sources in their phase average spectrum. And the only exception here is the black one, that is J1856. And its spectra is compatible with a perfect black body with the hint of a second colder component. The origin of this broad absorption feature is still under debate and clear, and they might be due to either proton cyclotron resonance or atomic transition in a magnetized atmosphere, or by inhomogeneous surface temperature distribution. But XDINs are not the only isolated neutron star to show this feature in their X-ray spectra, but as we have seen during these talks, we have the CC1, like few examples of these other sources, like the CCOs 1E1207 was the first one to show such strong absorption feature in the spectra. So here in the bottom panel, there are show, the bottom panel show the residual with respect to just a black body component. So this highlight the presence of absorption feature, and here we have harmonically spaced absorption feature at 0.7, 1.4, 2.1 EV. But also among the radio pulsar, we have few examples, such as the pulsar J1740 with a feature around 0.6 kV, or the highly magnetized RAT J1819 with a feature around 1 kV. But also, like the highly magnetized magnetars, show absorption feature, and this, in this case, the feature can lie both in the thermal and non-thermal part of the spectrum. And moreover, the feature are present in both in the persistent activity or during outburst. So here we have few claims like the soft gamma ray repeaters J1806 or the anomalous X-ray pulsar J1708 and the transient magnetar J1810. But these claims need to be confirmed by future observation. Few years ago, phase-dependent absorption feature have been discovered in two low magnetic field magnetar, SGR0418 and the SWIFT J1822. For the first case, the energy of the line is really phase-dependent, and it's above 2 kV. And for the former case, the energy of the line is about 6.5 kV. And if we interpret this line as proton cyclotron line, the magnetic field, the inferred magnetic field is above 10 to the 14 Gauss. These findings have motivated our search for phase-dependent absorption feature in the X-ray spectra of X-DINs, because according to magnetothermal evolution model, X-DINs are thought to be aged magnetar. So we, first of all, we analyzed the longest XMM Newton observation available for each of the X-DINs, focusing on the EPIC PN data. And for each of them, we built the energy versus phase image, just like binning the source count in energy and the rotational phase bin, and then normalizing the energy by the phase average spectra and the pulse profile. So for example, here in JO720, we can see a feature that is present just in a restricted interval phase. And this is due by the lack of photons with respect to the energy, nearby energy channel. And this gives a hint for a presence of a phase-dependent absorption feature. We can see also similar feature, let's say like blob, also in J1308 in two different phase intervals. But we have like this kind of blob also in other sources, but this didn't appear as significant as the first two examples. So we we detected the first phase-dependent absorption feature in JO720. And this neutron star has been discovered as an isolated neutron star pulsating at a period of 8.4 seconds. And here in the plot, we have the phase average spectrum, well modeled by a black body component plus a broad absorption feature. This source is the only one that has shown variation in timing and spectral parameters. And here in the panel C, we can see the residual in phase for a simple spin-down model, and they are well fitted by a glitch model, that is the dashed red line. And in panel D, we have the residual in spin frequency between a simple spin-down model and a glitch model. And there is like this jump that is possibly due to a glitch. So we built the energy versus phase image for the longest XMM Newton observation, and we noticed this feature that is present in this like restricted phase bin, and it's dominant during the decline of the pulse profile. And here is plotted in the top panel, and in black is for the combined spectrum that we obtain merging all the available XMM Newton observation, and in red is for the longest observation. So thanks to this hint, we proceeded to analyze all the XMM Newton observation for this source. So for each of the observation, we built the energy versus phase image. And here you can see that the blue line highlights the presence of the feature, and it's present in most of the observation. So this suggests that the line is stable over the time span covered by the observation, that this is about 12 years, and it's not linked to the timing event, to the glitch event. So after the next step was to perform a phase-resolved spectral analysis. So we divided the rotational phase in five bins, and for each of them we extracted the corresponding spectrum. So here in the plot we have in black the spectrum relative to the phase bin where we detected the line, and in red is the spectrum corresponding to another phase bin. And we see, and the residual are the residual respect to a simple black body model. So we see that the red spectrum is well modeled by a black body model. Instead, we can see some structure residual around 0.8 kV for the black model. In fact, the inclusion of a Gaussian line in absorption leads to an improvement in the residual of the spectrum. To obtain a preliminary estimate for the significance of the line, we use the F-test, but we know that a more rigorous approach requires Monte Carlo simulation. So we simulated 10 to the 5 spectra according to the null model, null hypothesis, that in this case is just a black body model. And then we fit this spectra with the alternative model, that is black body model plus this Gaussian line in absorption. And we can see from the plot that none of the simulated spectra show an absorption line with an equivalent width higher than the observed value, that is the red line. So the probability of the line being a fluctuation is less than 10 to the minus 5, and we can interpret this value as a p-value, and this p-value corresponds to a confidence level of 4.6 sigma. So this Monte Carlo simulation confirm our detection of a phase-dependent absorption feature in the X-ray spectra of J0720. We proceed with the same analysis in J1308, and also in this case, the phase average spectra is well modeled by a black body component and a broad absorption feature. And J1308 is the only one among the Magnificent Seven that show a double peaked pulse profile. So we proceed in the same way. So we build the energy versus phase image for all the XMM Newton observation available. And we noticed that this observation show an additional feature in a certain rotational phase. So first of all, we test the significance of the line under different assumption for the continuum model. So we change like the model for the broad absorption feature, or we use different cross-section and the abundance value for the photoelectric absorption model, and just one of these line appeared to be significant. So we focus on the interval of 0.4, 0.6 in phase, and so we proceed again with a phase resolved analysis. And here in the plot, we have the simultaneous fit for this interval, and also in this case, the inclusion of Gaussian line in absorption improves the residual of the fit. And again, we performed the Monte Carlo simulation also for this line, and also in this second case, none of the simulated spectra show an equivalent width higher than the observed value. So the Monte Carlo simulation confirmed the detection of this phase-dependent feature for also for these XDINs. For the other XDINs, we derived three sigma per limit for a presence of a Gaussian line in absorption for the phase average spectra with width of 0 electron volt, that means narrower than the energy resolution of the instrument, in this case the EPIC-PN camera, and with a width of 100 dB. Here on the plot, there is the 1 sigma per limit on a detectable flux variation with respect to the continuum model as a function of energy, and this can be related to the detectability of a feature in the spectra. So to sum up, we search for phase-dependent absorption feature in all the XDINs using energy versus phase versus flux diagrams, and we found phase-dependent features in 2 XDINs, and for all the others we derived 3 sigma upper limit. Because of the strong dependence on the phase, this line, it might be due to proton cyclotron resonance scattering in a small loop close to the stellar surface. So knowing the energy of the line, we can derive the strength of the magnetic field in the loop. And for both cases, the magnetic field in this bundle is much higher than the dipolar magnetic field strength. So this interpretation supports the scenario according to which the magnetic field of highly magnetized neutron star is much complex than a pure dipole configuration, but also show a small bundle close to the surface. And we observe similar feature in 2 low magnetic field magnetar. So this detection in XDINs strengthened the evolutionary link between XDINs and magnetar, because magnetar are thought to be descendant of magnetar. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. Very interesting work, and thank you for taking less time than your allocated time, so we have time for questions.
Thank you, Alice, for this talk. I would like just to point out that there was this result by Valerie Hambarian on 0720 that actually shows that the most likely period of the neutron star is twice that value, so around 70 seconds.
Yes.
Oh, okay. So you did take this into account.
Yes.
And this doesn't change your results
for
the narrow feature.
So we folded the light curve at the new claimed period, that is double, twice of the, let's say, old period, the one we used for our work. And we can see here there is the new energy versus phase image, and we can see that the line is present in 2 intervals as we expected, because we are folding the light curve as a period that is twice the old one.
Okay. And another thing, if I may, could you also comment on the difference between this feature that you found on the XDINSs in comparison to the ones on old magnetars, in special this time scale for this feature to appear? Because in old magnetars, they seem to be gone after some time. But at the Magnificent Seven, they are at least stable for 10 years or something like that.
So like the time modeling for the time scale is not still available because it depends on like many parameters such as the magnetic field configuration at Borghese or the conductivity of the grass. So as you say, the time scale can vary from like, let's say, days, month, if this loop is connected to magnetic instability, or can last for like in this case, 12 years or 6 years, and maybe it's because like the star is already born with this kind of loop. But we can't really like say much about time scale for this feature.
Other questions? I have a question. Why did you have to assume that it's a loop on the neutron star surface for the interpretation?
Because, like, so we see this line just in a limited portion of the, let's say, of the phase cycle. Mm-hmm. So we need to assume that it's a loop in a confined period. Mm-hmm. Yeah, sorry, in a confined region of like the star. So then we can see the line only in this interval phase. Right. When, like,
but could we be seeing evidence of a toroidal, a stronger toroidal component of the magnetic field? Because you're saying this is showing that these are descendants of older magnetars, but I'm also thinking, what if they are descendants of CCOs and we're seeing some reemergence of some topology of the magnetic field? Can you rule that out, or can you say something about it?
Like, we didn't consider this opportunity, but I think that it could be, like, we will think about that.
Okay.
Thank you. Right.
Any other questions? If not, let's thank Alicia again and move to the next speaker.